So this week, Evernote introduced some interesting updates in terms of stability, AI, and pricing. Today, we're going to overview everything that you need to know about that update, giving you a breakdown of all of those announcements, including some holistic announcements as a company for Bending Spoons, and also my personal opinion on where I think this is heading in the future. This video will have all the timestamps below, but if you are lucky enough or you want to really dig deeper into the Evernote journey, we've actually been able to secure a text interview with them, which you can find linked below exclusively over on Toolfinder. So you can find that linked in the description below, as well as if you find near the end of this video, you're like stressed out, you want some alternatives to Evernote, there will be Toolfinder to help you find alternative note-taking apps. So welcome, my name is Francesco Alessio. Let's dive into a little bit of an introduction to get things going. So Evernote introduced this announcement, and what was most interesting is it was actually run by Federico, who's one of the product designers over at Evernote. And it was more of a retrospective look at what's coming with Evernote, the pricing changes, and what they're actively doing to improve stability. Now, this is a really interesting update because, more importantly, it's Bending Spoon's first ever announcement as part of acquiring Evernote. So it's a really important one because it sets the tone for what is going to be coming in the future. And a lot of these updates aren't necessarily long distance away. Actually, a lot of them are short-term based, which is going to be really interesting for where you're heading with Evernote if you're using it. So let's start by talking about the reliability and stability aspects and the core fabric of Evernote. So according to Bending Spoons, they're in a rapid development phase in terms of improving the infrastructure and product development, as well as being able to ship a lot faster. Now, this has been one of Evernote's biggest issues in the last 5 years, but more recently in the last 2 to 3 years, they've really improved the core groundings of the application, making it more stable, replacing the initial code base, which is very much a big job. And now that Bending Spoons have got hold of this, they are aiming to improve at the performance and reliability. In particular, they're looking to improve the important structural changes when it comes to syncing notes, which has been a problem for a lot of users in the past. And what they want to do is make that smoother in terms of how it syncs on different devices. According to Evernote, on May the 5th, which may or may not be released by the time we publish this video, they're expecting all Evernote users to see the frequency of same note conflicts dramatically reduce, and in most cases, could be completely eliminated. So this is great news for those who have had those stability issues ever since they've moved to the Electron-based application, which runs the core structure of Evernote. But at the same time, is something that a lot of people have wanted to see for some time. They're also looking soon after to improve the release of further changes to make new notes synchronize across devices way faster. So in terms of looking at the core elements of Evernote, they're actually improving that major issue that people have with syncing starting May 5th, which is a great update to give you something immediate that they're improving from the platform. So interestingly, there are a lot of new features coming to Evernote, and two of them correlate to AI, and one of them is something that I believe Evernote have been working on for some time. Let's start with that feature. That first feature is something called real-time editing. And you're probably wondering, I've seen this in Google Docs and other experiences like that. And of course you have. It's very much a common part of a productivity application in most of the sort of team-based ones. Well, essentially from the 5th of May, real-time editing will be rolled out to users. And this will allow users to essentially start typing on their phone and see live visual updates on their laptop so that you can see the note being synchronized in real time. And this is sort of leading on from the reliability and stability improvements from note conflicts, because they've been able to match up real time to that stability and reliability side of stuff. So it's really great to see an update like this, but it also allows people to do real time updates and editing and see what other people are doing in real time. allowing you to see and work with other people, updating in notes elements and improving it, and actually seeing the cursors and interactions in real time. So this actual update is actually a lot more expansive for teams and those who are using it in groups. So this is definitely something that could be quite exciting for Evernote's future. Leading on from that, they have announced the fact that they've got two AI features coming, but they have stated that the AI elements are something that users can opt into if they find it suitable. Now, actually, in part of the statement of these features, they're basically saying that they will give this access to users for 1 month, but after that, it will likely become a subscriber-only access, which naturally falls to their strengths in the artificial intelligence area. Now, apparently in May, it doesn't state what day, they're introducing the Evernote AI cleanup. And this essentially takes a note and it basically spring cleans it. It formats it, gives it structure, and makes it more noteworthy. I guess something that would look and make sense to somebody that you share externally with. So this is great for students who are compiling notes and just shoving stuff in and want to be able to reorganize it in a much more formulated fashion, or those who are potentially taking loads of meeting notes and quickly want to restructure the note. So this feature is apparently coming in May, and to be honest, it's actually not a bad one, something that a lot of other note-taking applications I haven't seen do, and it's a very unique one when it comes to AI, especially when you might have a lot of previous Evernote notes and you want to be able to re-AI clean them up in the past, and you want to be able to make them make sense, which I definitely have from my student days. The next AI feature is something they haven't actually given a date to, but they do state it's going to become in the latter stages of this year, which I thought to be a little bit further away than I thought. But it's essentially taking search, which has been something that a lot of users love and know very well because of the OCR scanning, handwriting scanning, and just general ability to search really, really well. They're taking that and adding AI, which means you can add more natural language searching whilst trying to find this particular note. This is really interesting and really helpful for users, but I would expect it to come a lot sooner. But of course, Evernote have been focusing a lot on that reliability and stability changes. And remember, I keep forgetting, we're already in May. So maybe it will come in September, we will see. So now is the point to dive into pricing. Now, Evernote have made pretty drastic changes to their pricing in the last couple of weeks. And they do state it's the first pricing change in 7 years, since 2016. And they give it a little bit of a use case of how Evernote has changed since 2016 and what it offers as a total experience. And to be honest, I'm a little bit on their side here. Naturally, when you've got an application that's evolved so much in the last couple of years, pricing does have to evolve and change to that. And because costs are going up, and naturally, experience are becoming more stable and improved, it definitely should be noted that that's something that will change over time. But I think it's the dramatic increase in price that a lot of people find very stressful. The personal plans will be priced at $14.99 and professional plans priced at $17.99 US. And that is quite a big and vast increase in pricing. But as you know, Bending Spoons is a pretty AI-focused company, so I think people will be paying for the subscriptions for AI-based functions. And at the moment, there's no drastic changes in what the pricing will be for the free plans, naturally at $0. Now, to be honest, I am looking at this in a whole global view of the market. Evernote is more of an all-round application and something that is pretty well grounded in a lot of people's systems. But it definitely, if you compare it to apps like Reflect Notes, Capacities, and Roam, the new pricing isn't hideously far away from that. For example, that pricing is around the $12 to $15 per month mark, and that offers considerably less features if you look at it from an all-round perspective. So when you look at what's happening in the market, obviously this isn't naturally a huge distance away from that, but if you look at it from where Evernote have come from, it's a drastic increase. So apparently they're introducing this new pricing from May 1st, 2023. Now to summarize, I want to talk about the bending spoons overall. Now, for those who didn't know, Bending Spoons is an Italian-based app developer, and they have been making applications for some time now, actually acquiring over 500 million users, and that's not including Evernote apparently, for all of their applications on all of their devices, which is pretty impressive. And they are one of the leading European app development companies that are making pretty distant and progressive movements in the space. And whilst Evernote is their biggest acquisition to date, they actually acquired an app from GoPro in 2018 called Splice. And they make a case in this article about how Splice has gone from being a sort of simplistic application to being very AI driven and being priced at $89.99 per year. So they have 100 million users on that application and a lot of them paying happily for the application that gives them better photo editing and improvements like that. Now, Bending Spoons has been a company that has laid off 129 of their Evernote staffers in February 2023. But they are probably going to be leaning up, focusing more in AI, which is their specialist area, and really trying to advance Evernote in the next couple of years. And I do appreciate small things like their team leaving their personal email inside of the thread. Obviously, don't everyone email them all at once, but it's great news that that sort of level of transparency is being able to offer to be able to provide feedback to their team. Now, to my opinions as an overall experience, now, I'm a little bit biased because the founder's called Francesco, one of their founding team has a last name Ferrari. You know, all of this, I'm just kidding. I don't have any biases. Evernote have found a lot of issues in the last sort of 5 to 6 to 7 years. Since Phil Libin has left, there's been a lot of difficulties in terms of positioning and dropping a lot of the audience. And one of the things that I think Evernote might struggle with is whilst they are adding a lot of AI advancements, this is only helpful if you've got a vast amount of note data. And some people do, but some people between 2016 or 2018 and now have dropped Evernote. So that's 5 years of not having that useful insight and useful data. And that's probably why they're doing some initial improvements on the note cleanup function, because that's almost an immediate feature that you can start using with AI. But in terms of the ability to utilize notes and make it more present on things like home pages, that's something that they might find a bit more difficult because users have naturally not been adding notes for many years. But I do have faith in Bending Spoons. They are probably one of the world's leading experts when it comes to developing AI-based applications. And for what I've seen of the market, I'm impressed with what they've offered and how they've done it. So I think it's been probably the perfect acquisition for Evernote. And we do have to remember that Evernote might not be the hardcore productivity app it was in the past, but naturally something that becomes a first-timer application for those who are finding a productivity and note-taking application. I think that's probably where their audience is going to be in the future. Maybe not so much the hardcore note-takers, at least for the next couple of years. So that was my thoughts, opinions, and everything you need to know about Evernote in the last couple of weeks. If you're interested, again, we've got an interview with Evernote that you can find linked in the description below. And naturally, you can find it on Toolfinder. But if you're looking for lots of alternatives or just a note-taking application that suits you, find it on Toolfinder. I think you'll find some great resources there in much more detail than I can explain on here. Anyway, folks, a big, big thank you for stopping by. What do you think about Evernote? Share it in the comments below. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button because it allows more people to see it. And if you're new, do subscribe. All right, folks, I will see you all very soon. Thank you very much for stopping by.